Welcome to e-learning in thermodynamics and flow dynamics of our bachelor program in renewable energies and environmental engineering. This video introduces the pressure-enthalpy diagram. It is a graphical representation of a fluid state variables and allows visualizing properties of fluids in a state and during a process. The diagram is often used for engineering refrigeration units and heat pumps. The pressure-enthalpy diagram shows the absolute pressure P on one axis and the specific enthalpy H on the other axis. The absolute pressure P in a fluid is the force per area the fluid exerts on a wall or on adjacent parts of a fluid. In order not to confuse absolute pressure from relative pressure, which is often used in practice, the unit bar is sometimes used with an additional A for absolute. The specific enthalpy H is the energy per unit of mass a fluid transports across a system boundary. We explain in another video that enthalpy H is composed of internal energy U and the work needed to move a mass of fluid across a system boundary, which is given by absolute pressure P times the specific volume V. The absolute pressure P is plotted on the vertical axis. The specific enthalpy H is plotted on the horizontal axis. Each point in the diagram corresponds to a state of a fluid. Its state variables have certain values: pressure P, temperature capital T, specific volume V, specific enthalpy H, and specific entropy S. Lines with constant specific enthalpy H are called isenthalpic lines. They stretch vertically because H is plotted on the horizontal axis. If a state of a fluid changes from state A at constant specific enthalpy H along an isenthalpic line to state B, we call it an isenthalpic change of state. Lines with constant pressure P are called isobaric lines. They stretch horizontally because P is plotted on the vertical axis. If a state of a fluid changes from state A at constant pressure P along an isobaric line to state B, we call it an isobaric change of state. While the specific enthalpy H on the horizontal axis is shown in a linear scale, the pressure P on the vertical axis is shown in a logarithmic scale. This can be seen in the distribution of isenthalpic and isobaric lines. We now are looking at the pressure-enthalpy diagram of R134a, a widely used refrigerant. We can see that the plane contains many lines in different colors, which are arranged in a chaos at first sight. For experts, such a diagram is a map allowing to see the behavior of a fluid at a glance. We are going to explain what these many lines actually mean. A pressure enthalpy diagram contains a dome-shaped area. It stretches from the line of saturated liquid on the left to the line of saturated gas on the right. Both saturation lines meet at the top in a critical point. To the left of a saturated liquid line, the fluid is in a liquid state and the specific enthalpy H is low. This is the area of a liquid phase. To the right of a saturated gas line, the fluid is in a gaseous state and the specific enthalpy H is high. This is the area of a gas phase. In the dome-shaped area between the lines of saturated liquid on the left and saturated gas on the right, both the liquid and the gaseous phases exist simultaneously. It is called two-phase domain or wet steam domain. If the fluid consists of a single component, the state in this domain is a mixture of a saturated liquid and a saturated gas in thermodynamic equilibrium with each other. In the left part, most of a fluid is liquid and only a small amount is gaseous. In the right part, most of a fluid is gaseous and only a small amount is liquid. Lines of constant vapor content X are indicated in the two-phase area. The vapor content X is the mass ratio of a gaseous fluid and is also called quality. If a state of a fluid moves from left to right in the two-phase domain, the quality X increases from 0 to 1 and the fluid is evaporating. If a state of a fluid moves from right to left in the two-phase domain, the quality X decreases from 1 to 0 and the fluid is condensing. If a state of a fluid is above a critical point, it is called a supercritical fluid or a supercritical gas. The transition from the liquid phase or the gaseous phase into the supercritical domain is not sudden, but smooth and continuous. If points with the same temperature are connected with each other, the isothermal lines become visible. In the two-phase domain of a pure substance, the isothermal lines are horizontal and run parallel to the isobaric lines. This means that in the two-phase domain of a pure substance, for example during evaporation or condensation, pressure and temperature are coupled with each other. If a state of a fluid changes from state A at constant temperature, capital T, along an isothermal line to state B, we call it an isothermal change of state. In each point of a diagram, the fluid has a certain specific volume, V, which is a volume per unit of mass of fluid. If points with the same specific volume are connected with each other, the isochoric lines become visible. If a state of a fluid changes from state A at constant specific volume, V, along an isochoric line to state B, we call it an isochoric change of state. In every point in the diagram, the fluid has a certain specific entropy, S. It is a measure for reversibility of processes. If points with the same specific entropy are connected with each other, the isentropic lines become visible. If a state of a fluid changes from state A at constant specific entropy S along an isentropic line to state B, we call it an isentropic change of state. This is the case if no heat is exchanged between system and environment and only reversible processes take place in the system. All these characteristics from different fluids can be shown in a pressure-enthalpy diagram. What refrigeration experts call R134A is called 1112 tetrafluorethane by chemists. Now we see a pressure-enthalpy diagram of methane and many other refrigerants. More about the practical usage of a diagram like this will be shown in part 2.